Hello everyone. In this lecture, I'm going to discuss about the sign and symptom that appears in a woman during last, final or the third trimester of pregnancy. So this is the period which falls in between 29 to 40 week of gestation. And this is the period where the pregnancy is now going to be terminate and everyone is waiting for a new life. Yes. So let's talk about the sign and symptom. And if we talk about the symptom first, the only symptom that the woman experiences throughout pregnancy is the amenorrhea, absence of menstruation. Okay. The second symptom is that the woman continuously feeling that her abdomen is enlarging more and more. Why? Because the fetus is growing continuously. Yes. So as the fetus grow continuously, she feels that her abdomen is also enlarging. But with this enlarging uterus, she felt many discomforts like palpitation, breathing difficulties, because as the height reaches near term at ensiform cartilage, she might feel difficulty in breathing because the diaphragm is slightly pushed upward, and because of that the breathing is slightly hampered. Okay. Now the next symptom is frequency of micturition. Yes, we talked it earlier also in the first trimester. So during first trimester also she might have this problem, because at that time once she conceive and once the fetus grow, the position of uterus is antiverted at that time. So with this antiverted position, when the fetus is growing, when the uterus is enlarging, this directly create pressure, or it exert a pressure over the bladder, and this may lead into the frequent urination. Yes. But in second trimester it subsides, because the height, the shape become ovoid, or it become just straighten up. Okay. So once it becomes straighten up, it just relieve the pressure over the bladder. But again in third trimester, as the uterus grow more and more with the enlarging fetus and amniotic fluid, so this all contribute a pressure again on the bladder, and that may lead into the frequent urination in third trimester also. Okay. So the woman usually complain of that she is having frequent urination. Okay. Then she felt many clear fetal movements. Yes. Quickening usually appear, or it start in second trimester onwards, but it is more pronounced, more clear in this third trimester, because once the baby is rolling, it is kicking, it is moving their limbs, then the woman can felt this all very clearly, because now the fetus is enlarged. Yes. So fetal movements are very clear now and more pronounced and more. Okay. Then the another symptom that the woman may felt is the lightening, that is a sense of relief from a pressure, because it is not happen in earlier weeks, because initially up to the 36th week of gestation the height goes up and up. Okay. And slightly the diaphragm is also displaced. Okay. But once the height goes down, it comes down, then the woman feels a relief of pressure and she feels comfortable. Okay. Because many discomforts she may have with this 36 week of pregnancy, but now it will be relieved after that, because it is not like that after 36 week of gestation the height goes up and up and up. After 36 week of gestation it goes down. Okay. So that we'll discuss later in sign. So the lightening is the another symptom that she may have. Okay. So what all symptom the woman may have during last trimester? That is the amenorrhea, then the enlargement of the uterus with the growing fetus, lightening, sense of relief from a pressure. Okay. Then the more frequent fetal movements and frequency of micturition. Okay. So these are the symptoms. Now we talk about the signs, what our examiner usually observes. So firstly, if we talk about the cutaneous or the skin changes, then these all pigmented areas like chloasma, stria gravidarums, the linear stretch marks, the pigmented zone around the breast, like in Naples and the areola, okay, and the linear Niagara, this all become darkened, this all become enlarged. Okay. So these all become more pigmented, the strias become enlarged, they are more in number, more stretched, more wide, more long. Okay. So there are many changes which start during second trimester of pregnancy, but these all become pronounced in this third trimester. Then if we talk about the uterine shape, initially in second trimester of pregnancy, what happened? The uterus become ovoid. But as it grows more and more, up to the 36th week of gestation, it becomes cylindrical. Okay, so the shape of the uterus becomes cylindrical, and once it comes down after 38 and 40 week of gestation, it becomes again round in structure, spherical in shape. Okay, so it changed from cylindrical to spherical in last few weeks. Okay, then the contraction which appears throughout pregnancy, that is the Braxton Hicks contraction, become more evident. That is irregular, infrequent, spasmodic, painless contraction, which are not causing any effect on dilatation of cervix. Okay, that already we discussed in second trimester of pregnancy. So these all Braxton Hicks contraction become more evident and more pronounced in this third trimester. Okay, the fetal movements are also more, fetal body parts are easily palpable, and with this easy palpation we can identify the lie, presentation and position of the fetus. So first we talk what is lie. So lie is the relationship between the fetus body part and the long axis of the centralized uterus or maternal spine. So normally if both the long axis are parallel, if both the long axis, fetal long axis is from head to buttock, and the long axis of the uterus is from fundal region to the cervical region. Yes. So if both the long axis comes closer in parallel manner, then this lie is called longitudinal, which is most common lie. Okay. So in majority of condition, the lie is longitudinal. But if it is goes, this long axis of the fetus goes slightly tilted in oblique manner, or it is creating transversely with this long axis of the spine or the uterus, then it is called oblique or transverse lie. But in majority, the lie is longitudinal. And with this palpation, we can identify the presentation, that which part of the fetus is usually occupying the lower pole of the uterus. So usually the head comes first. So when head is lying on the lower pole of the uterus, then we are calling as cephalic presentation. But if the head part is not there, if buttock is there, then we are calling the podalic presentation. And if the other part also combinedly comes in lower pole, like shoulder is there, then we can say shoulder presentation is there. Or if the shoulder, head region, neck, these all are coming, then we can call the compound presentation. So depending on which part of the fetus is coming down in the lower pole of the uterus, that is called presentation. And the another is the position. I'm not going in detail what is position, but just I'm giving what is the most common position is the left occipito anterior, where the occiput is the denominator, that is the bony fixed point which come in relation with the maternal pelvis. And when it comes anteriorly toward the left side, then we are called as left occiput anterior. So with the palpation of these all body part, we can identify what is the lie, presentation and position of the fetus right now. Okay, then if we talk about the fetal heart sound, then it becomes more clearly evident depending on the position and the presentation of fetus by an ordinary stethoscope. Yes, then if we talk about the fundal height, that is very important. So if we measure with the inch tape, symphysis fundal height, if we are measuring with the inch tape, so what we can do is that we just use our left hand and palpate where the height we are receiving, where is the highest point of the fundus. And with this ulnar border, we mark there, and we can place this inch tape from symphysis pubis till that highest point of the fundal region. And from there to there, we can measure in centimeter. Okay. So by this measurement, we can correlate the centimeter with the week of gestation. So suppose if we are getting 32 centimeter, it means that pregnancy is about 32 weeks. Okay. So if you are getting 32 centimeter, then the weeks would be 32 week of pregnancy, but there is plus minus of 2 centimeter should be considered normal. Like 32 cm we are getting, but if pregnancy is of 30 week of gestation or 34 week, then it is okay. Okay, because there is a consideration of this plus minus 2 cm. Okay, and the other method to calculate this fundal height is also there. Like we know that at the level of umbilicus, the week of gestation is about 24 weeks. Okay, and we are calculating the highest point, that is at the ensiform cartilage, the week of gestation is about 36 week of gestation. Okay, so I already told you in previous video also that how we can divide this whole region from umbilicus to ensiform cartilage. We divide this whole part in three equally. The uppermost region should be at the ensiform cartilage, and if we are getting the fundal height at ensiform cartilage, then the week of gestation is 36 week of gestation. Okay, then comes the another two points. Okay, so here is the ensiform cartilage, yes, and these are the two other points which are at equal distance, and then comes the umbilicus. Okay, so this point already we discussed that if we are getting at lower third region, then the week of gestation is about 28, but here I am discussing about the third trimester. So if we are getting the height in the middle third, in the middle third of this region, then the week of gestation is the 32 week of gestation. Okay, and if we are getting the fundal height at ensiform cartilage, then the weeks are 36 weeks. So how we calculate the 38 and 40 week of gestation, because it is not going up from ensiform cartilage. So after 36 week of gestation, when the height reaches till ensiform cartilage, now the height comes down. It not goes up, it comes down. Okay, so when it comes down, then the woman feels a sign of relief, because till ensiform cartilage the height is growing up and the diaphragm is also elevating, so that's why she is facing very many difficulties, breathing difficulties. So when the height comes down, the fundal height comes down from 36 weeks to 38 or 40 week of gestation, so when it comes down, the woman feels a sign of relief, that is called lightening. Okay, but now the another point is that if the height comes down, then how we can identify that the week of gestation is 32 or rather it is 38 or 40 week of gestation. So for that we can do palpation, and by the pelvic grip method we can identify whether head is engaged or not, because this is the parameter through which we can find out whether the week of gestation is of about 32 or it is 38 or 40 week of gestation. So if the head is floating, it has not come down in the pelvic cavity and it is floating, then the week of gestation is about 32. But once the height goes down after 36 week of gestation, when it comes down and it enters into the pelvic cavity, it enters into the pelvic brim, so once it entered, the head become engaged, because the head is the cephalic region is the normally the region which comes down and it become engages. Okay, so once it become engaged, the height comes down. Okay, so if the head is engaged, if the head is engaged, and if we found by this pelvic grip, okay, pelvic grip palpation, then we can call it as that this is the 38 to 40 week of gestation. This is not the pregnancy of 32, it is the pregnancy of 38 to 40 week of gestation. Okay, so these are the signs which we can observe, like cutaneous changes, the change in the uterine shape, okay, more Braxton Hicks contraction, the palpation of fetal body parts, the change in the fundal height, symphysis fundal height you can measure, and you can evident or auscultate fetal heart sound. Okay, so in this lecture we have discussed what all signs and symptoms the woman may have during third trimester of pregnancy. Thank you.